So here it is, two-thirds into January, and there's just all kinds of stuff popping up. All the little bulbs are coming up. Oh man, it's crazy. So I figure that they know something I don't. And I think it's going to be a pretty warm spring. So here's the garden. All kinds of stuff rolling up there. Very nice. Oh yeah, Lenten rose. A couple of them, there's a white one back there. I mean, does this look like January? I mean, this is Pacific Northwest Maritime. Sorry about the tarps, there's some old cut wood under there. Guest house up there. Yeah, I mean, stuff is just coming up. Look at that. That's amazing. So, not as much out in the woods as I would have thought, but the non-native stuff is definitely coming up. Some big firs. My little smoking spot. So typical Pacific Northwest morning. Kind of like mostly overcast. You know, I grew up in Denver, and so there it's like 300 plus sunny days a year. Here it's 300 plus cloudy days a year. Took a little getting used to it, yeah. But it's great. I mean, anywhere you live is a great place, honestly. So I'm doing something I don't normally do. This is some Burley from Mac Baron. Burley. 100% Burley, long matured to bring out this golden brown superior blend. The usual florid description. Description-eering. So this is a pipe I just acquired. A vintage, no-name, imported briar, so carved in the U.S. Black teeth. It's another thing about this climate, it encourages hot drinks. Yeah, when I first got here, it was like, I just couldn't get warm, you know? It's humid and cool to cold. It's just, and just something about the gray and the green, both enervating colors, kind of bring it, you know? So it's been a challenge. I've been here a long time, but. So anyway, I acquired this pipe. You know, on eBay for, how much did I pay for this? I'm thinking like $7 or $8, and that was a couple bucks. I always look at shipping, you know, oh, $10 to ship it. Well, if you're going to insure it, you know, Rob Cooper's kind of, Cooper's Ark has kind of been good at informing me about that. It does, if you're going to insure and you're going to pack well, it costs a little bit to ship, you know, so. But this was cheap shipping, and I just kind of like the look of the pipe. I like a saddle bit. So I cleaned it up, reamed it out with my pocket knife. I know you're not supposed to do that, but boy, it sure works for me. Whoever had smoked this, there was quite a bit of cake in it, and oh yeah, you can still smell. I mean, I don't know what they smoked, but very aromatic. So possibly a hopelessly ghosted pipe. So I'm gonna, I don't know why, I just kind of had this desire to give some Burley a try. Normally it gives me a tongue bite. And I was thinking from my reading that it was due to the alkaline chemistry of Berlin, combining with my chemistry on my tongue. So we'll see. I do feel a little something on my tongue. So we'll see. This is something that was given to me. God, I would never buy it. But, if Burley didn't bite me, I would probably be more of a fan. Although it doesn't have a whole lot of flavor for me. The tin aroma was a little hay-like, grassy almost. Kind of like a good Virginia, you know. Or a fresh Virginia. They mentioned chocolate notes in here, and I can see that through the power of suggestion. And usually Burley has quite a bit of nicotine, and I am not a Nick fan at all. A little dried up. It came to me from some friends of mine up by Camino Island. And they were getting rid of a whole bunch of tobacco and had a little dibs of this, dabs of that, mostly, almost entirely aromatics, most of which I've given away. Thank you, Dan. I think it went to a good home there. This may not be fully representative. Fresh tin, just a little dry, but you know, it's actually better than I thought. It is a smoother, more superior experience to any of the domestic Burleys, which probably aren't all Burley anyway, you know, they're mixtures. So, who knows? Every tobacco mix is a mixture, and it's a mixture from year to year. You know, your favorite Virginia from Zimbabwe, you know, next year is going to taste different because climatic conditions, soil conditions, moisture, it's all going to change. So, chances are good it's going to be a different smoking experience next year. So, how these guys, I remember reading an article in Pipes and Tobaccos, where they visited Mac Baron, and they said their biggest challenge was to keep things consistent from year to year to year in these different tobaccos, so it met people's expectations. And it would be a big challenge. And yet that's part of the experience, too, for me, with this different tobacco, is it's always kind of different. And like today, Saturday morning, I'm relaxed. I have some things I have to do today, but you know, it's just like it's great out here having a smoke versus last week when it was rainier and windier, and I was kind of thinking about what I had to do at work because I was going to work pleasantly on the trail, but still, you know, your mind's kind of looking ahead. So our smoking experience is always different. Each smoking experience is going to be different. And that's cool. I like it. So anyway, back to this pipe. Really tight grain. I mean, seriously tight grain. So, if this was a real quality pipe, I suspect it would have, you know, been stamped Ehrlich from Boston or whatever. Just a classic shape, classic billiard shape. The stem might be a little long for my taste, you know, I'd like a shorter saddle bit rather than cut it inch to an inch and a half off, but certainly an inch. To me, would make that look better. So, I'm having fun. And so for a total cost, including shipping, of like $10. So I reamed it out, It was already 5:30 seconds. Nice. The bit was in pretty good shape, so I slipped on one of the, cut a little piece of vinyl tubing, heated it up in some my tea water here. Slipped it on, you know, daubed it with some bourbon on a pipe cleaner, and I couldn't wait to smoke it. So that's what I'm doing right now, first time. And you can, there's something, it's almost like perfume, you know, the ghosting from those aromatics. And I cannot tell. Was it a cherry? Was it Captain Black? Was it, who knows? But definitely aromatic. Can't really taste it so much. A little bit. But, you know, my palate just isn't refined, I'm realizing. Yeah. Oh, notes of granite mixed with blueberry, pomegranate, poultice that hides playfully in the background. You know, so. Really? Okay. Thank you, Doug. Prometheus lighter from Cargo Hold. Too nice to just carry around and lose, so that's why I normally either carry a Bic or a little box of matches. I really prefer matches. A lighter can't be beat for efficiency. That is one thing about Burley, it just burns down to white ash. It really does. And they didn't mention a top note on here at all, any additive. Oh, just a little Virginia tobacco has been added to give the blend a natural sweet. Okay, well, but you never know if they've thrown a little, not gelatin, but a similar substance to keep it moist, you know. Mm-hmm. Where are the days of the British non-adulteration of tobacco laws? Nice, I can taste a little pipe residue in there. But, you know, it's just part of the pipe. It's the patina of the pipe. So take it or leave it. I don't know what it is, but I just kind of like this pipe. So. And, you know, who knows who smoked this before? Probably some older guy. I'm stereotyping now. Somewhere, who's probably gone now, you know, got goodwilled in some antique shop in Mississippi, picked it up, and then has an eBay shop and offered it on that, you know, something like that. So this bite may have had some great experiences, may have had some sad experiences, you know, smoking, who knows. But that's all part of the patina of the pipe. And that's why I'm fond of estate pipes. You know, I don't know what the history of this pipe is other than aromatic. But it looks like it was pretty well taken care of and not abused and not super, super heavily smoked. Although it's got a little char on the rim and a little deposit. And it's not like every estate pipe will be a quality pipe. You know, the cheapest, cruddiest basket pipes could have found the same pathway to me. And are out there, certainly. But this happens to be a quality pipe. The wood is great. I mean, I don't have a pipe that has finer grain than that, which indicates to me, like old growth briar.